Hi, my name is Margaret Chapman, and I have been an Immaculate Heart of Mary sister for 42 years. And I'm 60 years old, and the question that I have in my hand that I'm going to respond to is, how many careers have you had as a sister? Before I answer that directly, I should say that a friend of mine who kind of accompanied me, another IHM sister, who accompanied me in the decision-making process when I was in high school, used to say to me, probably about 15 or 20 years ago, Margaret, she'd say, wouldn't it be nice if you just found one career and were happy at it for your whole life? I'd say, I don't know if that would be nicer or what. But anyway, when I saw this question, I was just telling Julie that I've had five careers since I have been professed. I started out trained as a teacher, which we all had to be trained as, and did my student teaching, and that was enough in terms of teaching. Enough for them and enough for me. So I was offered a position in the middle of the year to do parish ministry in inner city parish in Detroit. That was in 1972, and I had no clue as to what parish ministry meant. And the person who was offering it to me, another IHM, said, oh, it's kind of like social work, Margaret. And I said, oh, okay, I can do that. Sure. And I needed a job. So I took that and was very happy doing parish ministry for a few years. And then left that ministry and took a clinical pastoral education course and became a hospital chaplain. And I was a hospital chaplain on and off for about 8 years. And then my community asked me if I would do some work in the area of formation and vocation recruitment. So I said yes and did that for 7 years, and then figured I had done enough for the community and didn't want to work for the church either by that time. I knew that, so I wasn't going to go back to parish work. So actually, I did an internship in affordable housing management with Mercy Housing, Inc., which was a wonderful experience, and came back to Detroit and was the assistant manager in two HUD senior citizen complexes on our college campus in Detroit, and was actually enjoying that very much until the community asked me to become its development director. And I said yes again, and was actually the development director, raising money and friends, etc., for another 9 years. Left that position recently, and was invited once again by the community to start a whole new ministry. A lawyer friend of ours had come to the leadership and asked, he was in court-appointed guardianship and conservatorship work in the Detroit area, and he came to the community and said, you know, I think that the work that I do is really good work that sisters could do, and there's great need for it, and there might be some compensation in it as well, and they don't need any new credentials, new licensing, new, you know, degrees or anything like that. So anyway, the leadership was interested in starting this ministry, and I hadn't taken another position yet after the development job. So they said, would you take the lead on getting this up and going? And I said, what is it? What is a guardian? You know, I didn't know any more about what a guardian was than anything, except I see on all the medical forms, you know, you could, if you couldn't sign yourself, you could have a parent or guardian sign for you. Well, since that never applied to me, I didn't think, you know. Anyway, so now I'm, for the last 2 years, I've been working in court-appointed guardianship and conservatorship work with 5 other IHMs. And we've expanded and turned it into a for-profit business called Compassionate Companions, Inc. So, I think that's actually 6 careers. I thought it was only 5, but I forgot the affordable housing one. So, anyway, that's my story. So, if you're looking at religious life and you think that in some way it's going to stifle your ability to do things that you never even thought about doing, wrong. Take it from me.